The mind is a masterly telemarketer. Don't pick up the phone. Telemarketers are marketing executives who are expert at marketing and selling people products through the telephones. If some unsuspecting, undiscerning customers pick up the phone call, then these marketers can persuade so persuasively, so powerfully, so alluringly that the people who had no idea that such a product existed, who had no desire for a particular product, may by the end of a conversation start feeling that I just have to get this product and whatever I'm required to pay for it, I'll pay for it. So how did this happen? The desire gets injected into the mind. And as the telemarketer keeps speaking, their speech increases the desire within the potential customer. So here, the expertise is used to kindle and inflame the desire within the person so that as to force that person to buy. Now, our mind is inside us, and that makes it an even more seductive and sinister telemarketer. So normally, if anybody outside us of us proposes something to us, we evaluate the suggestion. Maybe I'll do it, maybe I won't. But when an idea comes from inside us, we think of that idea as our own idea, and we very unsuspectingly, uncritically, unthinkingly accept it. And the mind is extremely powerful in giving such a spin to things that we feel as if I must have this and I must have it right now. Now, things that we don't need at all, the mind can make us feel that we can't not have them, that we must have them and we can't live without them and we need them right now. This is the deceptively dangerous deluding capacity of the mind. The Bhagavad Gita cautions us that the mind can be our friend as well as our enemy. In 6.5 it states that Uddharedatmanatmanam natmanam avisadayet atmaivayatmano bandhur atmaiva ripuratmanah. So he says we should elevate ourselves with the mind and not degrade ourselves. Atmaivaya atmano bandhur. The mind can be our friend and the mind can be our enemy. So how do we know in what way the mind is acting when? Now that we have to have some reference point beyond the mind. Now whereas we, with respect to telemarketers, if they are calling, we can see what number is there, and if it is an unfamiliar number, we can decide we will not pick up the phone. But because the mind is inside us, it is much more difficult to resist the mind. It's even more difficult actually to recognize what the mind is saying in advance. And so just as if we could identify, okay, this seems to be the number of some unknown person, this might be a telemarketer, I won't pick it up. So then we would be able to better protect ourselves. So like that, when the mind starts suggesting things, is there a way by which we can know which of the mind suggestions are destructive and which constructive? Because Krishna also acknowledges that the mind can be our friend. And as a friend, it can act constructively. So, for the mind to act constructively, what we need is this point that we have to have some reference point which will enable us to evaluate. And that reference point is scriptural study. If we study the Bhagavad Gita regularly, then the Bhagavad Gita helps us to understand our desires. The world is talking about just fulfilling desires. Come on, eat this, touch this, enjoy this, watch this. But the Bhagavad Gita gives us a reference point by which we can understand and evaluate our desires. And if we are regularly studying the Bhagavad Gita, then when the call comes, when the mind starts prompting something, then immediately it's like on our phone we have an identity determining app, which shows, oh, it is this kind of desire. This desire is not worthy. Therefore, I will not pay attention to it. And if just as if a person may call, But if we don't pick up the phone, they can't, that person can't intrude into our life. So like that, if we don't give attention to what the mind is saying, the mind can't force itself on us. More importantly, if we turn our mind towards something constructive, then the mind becomes totally disempowered. So by recognizing that the mind will delude us, if we listen to it, we can avoid listening to it by having a reference point through scripture to know which of the ideas of the mind are not worth listening to. Thank you. Hare Krishna.